I'm Tom Perrotta, the author of Mrs. Fletcher. The subject matter is sex and identity. And that might sound serious, but it is about a 46-year-old divorced woman who is left alone after her son goes to college. And Eve is alone, and she's feeling like, hey, what about me? You know, why can't I have some fun? And one of the things she does is actually take a college course.
Right.
And she ends up having the kind of adventures that maybe some college students have. And I think part of the comedy of the book is just watching a 46-year-old woman behave like a college kid.
So not only is she discovering herself, she's also set into a new world where suddenly she's no longer needed.
This chapter of her life is over, the chapter of being a mom. And I think anyone who's been a parent knows that when kids are little, it just feels like this thing will never end. Like some of those days are endless. And you just feel like this is my life now. But then that life ends. She's not old, but she's not sure who she is besides mom. And in fact, you know, she's not Mrs. Fletcher anymore either. This is the name that was sort of left over from her marriage. And really the book is about shedding Mrs. Fletcher and finding what's next.
They juxtapose each other. So Brendan goes to college and he's going to be this jock and he's going to have this incredible, wonderful time. And his time doesn't go how he expects it. She goes and becomes enlightened. So did you have fun doing the two of them?
Yeah, well, you know, she wants him to have what we think of as the sort of ideal college experience, mm-hmm. which is your mind gets opened, your world gets expanded. You grow beyond the parochial limits of your small town life. You meet new, different people. But Brendan he's a jock, and he's a little defensive. He would rather still be in high school, mm-hmm. actually. In high school, he was popular. He was an athletic star. He had an identity and that he was really comfortable with. And he arrives at college at a time when, you know, guys like him aren't the undisputed kings that they used to be. And he gets some pushback from people. And on the other hand, Eve takes a gender and society class taught by a transgender professor. There's just a really wide variety of people mm-hmm. in her class. There are adults who work, there are college kids, there are immigrants. It's almost like the idealized version of college that she's hoping Brendan's gonna have, but she's the one who gets it.
Right. Thank you so much for being here. It was very enlightening.
Well, thank you for having me.
And thank you for watching A Word on Words. I'm JT Ellison. Keep reading. Okay, so last question. Who sent the text?
Well, I think I know, but I don't want to. I think the reader should figure that out.
Maybe when the cameras stop, you'll tell me.
Yeah, okay.